Hello all, very good morning. So let us continue solving the numerical problems on electrochemical cell which is used in potentiometric method of analysis. So far we have solved a few problems. So based on the solution what we have obtained and the way of solving those problems, we have got the knowledge how to determine the E cell value for any given electrochemical cell. And the determination of the E cell value may be for the half cell or the overall cell, and in an alternative way we can say that it may be applicable for cathodic cell and anodic cell. So if E cell value is known, if a potentiometer displays an E cell value, from the E cell value we are able to determine the concentration of the species which is involved in the formation of the electrochemical cell. And the solution may be in concern with either to the cathode or anode. If the cathode is immersed into the aqueous solution of the analyte, the cathodic potential will be employed, and by means of which we can determine the concentration of the solution into which the cathode has been determined. If the anode is immersed into the aqueous analyte solution, in the similar manner what we have done to calculate the concentration of the analyte into which the cathode is immersed, the anodic potential can be used and the concentration of the analyte can be determined. So here this is another typical example by means of which you can calculate the cell voltage by using the chemical reactions given here. So this is said that determine the reaction between the following reactions and calculate the E cell, means the cell voltage. The given reactions are Fe3 plus electron gives rise to Fe2 plus. So the standard state reduction potential for this particular off reaction is 0.771 volts, and similarly the other off reaction given is triiodide ion plus 2 electrons gives rise to iodide ion, and the standard state reduction potential for the reduction of triiodide ion to iodide is 0.5355 volts. So you can see these two off reactions. These are the two off reactions which are possible when we are going to perform the analysis of iodine by using the solution containing iron 3+. So if you see the potential, the standard state reduction potential for these two off reactions, the standard state reduction potential or the E0 value for iron 3 iron 2 couple is more positive when compared to the E0 value of I3 minus I minus couple. So E0 value of this particular off reaction is greater than the E0 value of this particular off reaction. So if this is more positive among iron 3 plus and I3 minus, iron 3 plus is going to be the strong oxidizing agent. Similarly, if a species is having more negative standard state reduction potential, that species can be said as strong reducing agent. Here I3 minus is strong reducing agent than Fe3 plus, or Fe3 plus is a strong oxidizing agent than triiodide ion pair. Therefore here, because it has got the value of 0.771 volts, which is far greater than 0.5355 volts, iron 3 plus is powerful oxidizing agent when compared with I3 minus. Therefore iron 3 plus will oxidize iodide. Because iodide is a reducing agent, it will undergo oxidation to get converted to iodine. Iodine can also be written as I3 minus triiodide ion pair, because iodine will be in equilibrium with iodide ion to form triiodide ion pair. This is called as triiodide ion pair and this is iodide. So iron 3 plus will oxidize iodide to iodine. So the overall E0 of the cell, as we know, can be written as E0 of the cathode minus E0 of the anode, because cathode is present at the right hand side and anode will be present at the left hand side of the electrochemical cell. So E cathode minus E anode is going to give you E cell. Similarly, E0 of the cathode minus E0 of the anode is also going to give you E0 of the electrochemical cell. So E0 of the cathode means E naught of iron 3 iron 2 couple minus E naught of the anode means E naught of iodine iodide couple. So E naught of iron 3 iron 2 couple minus E naught of iodine iodide couple. You know the E naught values, so you can just substitute E naught of the cell is equal to plus 0.771 minus 0.5355. So if you simplify, you will get E naught of the cell is equal to plus 0.235 volts. So you can also become familiar about the overall reaction taking place while using this particular electrochemical cell containing iron 3 plus and triiodide ion pair can be written as 2 Fe3 plus plus 3 iodide gives rise to 2 Fe2 plus plus iodine or triiodide ion pair. So this I3 minus is associated by two electrons, one iron 3 plus if converted to one iron 2 plus, one electron has been added to Fe3 plus. There are two Fe3 plus, so two electrons are required. Two electrons are given by iodine, iodide. Iodide is the species undergoing oxidation. Iodide is the species undergoing oxidation. So electrons are released from the iodide. So electrons are captured by iron 3 plus to get converted to Fe2 plus. So this is the overall reaction you can write. For this overall reaction, E naught of the cell, which can be calculated as plus 0.235 volts. So this is how you can calculate the E naught value or E cell value for these type of chemical reactions. Let us move on to the next one. This is somewhat interesting problem. And these type of problems are very, very essential in order to calculate the concentration of the species by using the E cell value. If you see the problem here, a 5 ml of 0.10 molar cerium 4 plus solution is added to 5 ml of 0.30 molar iron 2 plus solution. Calculate the potential of a platinum electrode dipping in the solution, and the potential will be relative to normal hydrogen electrode, and the standard state reduction potential for iron 3 iron 2 couple is given as 0.771 volts. So what you have to calculate, generated due to the reaction between cerium 4 and iron 2. The reaction takes place between cerium 4 and iron 2. What they did, if you look at the problem seriously, a 5 ml solution of 0.3 molar iron 2 plus is taken, into which 5 ml of 0.1 molar cerium 4 plus has been added. So this is a strong reducing agent and this is a strong oxidizing agent. When you mix cerium 4 plus with iron 2 plus, what will happen? Redox reaction takes place. Iron 2 plus undergo oxidation to get converted to iron 3 plus, and cerium 4 plus undergo reduction to get converted to cerium 3 plus. So for the couple iron 3 iron 2 couple, the E naught value is given as 0.771 volts. So what you have to calculate? You have to calculate the E cell value. Platinum electrode is used here as electrodes of the third kind or inert redox electrode. And here the platinum electrode will act as a source, a sink for electrons. So electrons are released from iron 3 plus. So platinum electrode will act as a sink for those electrons. And it will act as a source for electrons when the electrons are required to be added to cerium 4 plus. So if you write the overall reaction, iron 2 plus plus cerium 4 plus gives rise to iron 3 plus plus cerium 3 plus. So you know what is the amount of iron 2 plus taken, that is 0.3 molar into 5 ml, you will get 1.5 millimoles. 0.3 molar of 5 ml iron 2 plus solution is taken, that is going to give you 1.5 millimoles. Similarly, what is the amount of cerium 4 plus added? The amount of cerium 4 plus added is 5 ml of 0.1 molar, that is going to give you 0.5 millimoles. Therefore, the amount of iron 2 plus left, so this is the overall amount of iron 2 plus taken, This is the amount of cerium 4 plus added. Since the reaction between iron 2 plus and cerium 4 plus is going to be 1 is to 1. So, so many moles of iron 2 plus is going to react with the same moles of cerium 4 plus. Therefore, 1.5 is the number of millimoles of iron 2 plus taken initially. So, after the addition of cerium 4 plus in an amount 0.5 millimoles, 0.5 millimole of iron 2 plus undergo oxidation to get converted to iron 3 plus. So, remaining iron 2 plus is 1.5 minus 0.5, that is going to give you 1.0 millimoles. So, the amount concentration of iron 2 plus left, the amount of iron 2 plus left is 1.0 millimoles. Therefore, the concentration of iron 2 plus leftover is equal to 1 millimole divided by total volume. Total volume is, so 5 ml of cerium 4 plus has been added. Initial volume of iron 2 plus was 5 ml. So 5 plus 5, you are going to get 10 ml. Millimoles divided by volume, you are going to get moles per liter. So 1 by 10, you will get 0.1 molar. So this is the concentration of iron 2 plus left over after the redox reaction is completed. So in turn, the amount of cerium 4 plus added must be equal to amount of iron 3 plus form, and hence the concentration of iron 3 plus. So the concentration of iron 3 plus formed is going to be 0.5 millimoles divided by total volume, because millimoles of iron 3 plus formed will be exactly equal to millimoles of cerium 4 plus added. No other oxidizing agent has been added. Only cerium 4 is the dominating oxidizing agent, is the only one oxidizing agent which is going to oxidize iron 2 plus. Therefore, its amount, what is the amount of cerium 4 plus added? It is 0.5 millimoles. So what is the amount of iron 3 plus formed? It is 0.5 millimoles. So 0.5 millimoles divided by total volume, you are going to get moles per liter of iron 3 plus formed. So you are going to get 0.5 divided by 10, that is 0.05. So 0.05 molar iron 3 plus is formed in the solution into which platinum electrode has been immersed. So platinum electrode will be used as a cathode because it is going to be a working electrode. It is going to be indicator electrode, and it will act as a source of a sink for electrons. Therefore, this is a cathode, this is a working electrode, this is an indicator electrode. So the preferred reaction is reduction of iron 3 plus. Cathode is the electrode at which always reduction reaction takes place. Therefore, iron 3 undergo reduction in a way that Fe3 plus plus electron gives rise to Fe2 plus. Therefore, if you write the Nernst equation for this of reaction, E cell or E of iron 3 iron 2 couple is going to give you E0 of iron 3 iron 2 couple minus 0.05916 divided by N into log of Fe2 plus concentration divided by Fe3 plus concentration. So N value is 1 here because only one electron has been added to iron 3 plus. So N value will be getting the value of 1. And E0 value is already given in the problem. So if you just substitute, E cell or E of iron 3 iron 2 couple is going to give you 0.771 minus 0.0591 divided by 1 into log of the concentration of iron 2 plus is known, 0.1 molar, divided by concentration of iron 3 plus is 0.05 molar. If you just substitute and simplify, you will be getting the value of E is equal to 0.753 volts is the final answer. So calculate the potential of a platinum electrode dipping in the solution relative to normal hydrogen electrode. So here we are considering only cathode because normal hydrogen electrode is going to act as an anode. Its E value will be 0. So that's what E cell has not been written in the way of E cathode minus E anode, because E anode is going to become 0 here because we are calculating the E value in reference to normal hydrogen electrode. Normal hydrogen electrode is a reference electrode here. So E is equal to only E cathode. E cell will be equal to E cathode minus E anode value will be 0, therefore E value will be exactly E cathode. So for cathodic electrode, we have calculated the E value. This is going to be the final answer. Let us move on to the next problem. The problem given as, for the electrochemical cell platinum immersed into iron 2 plus solution of concentration 0.150 molar, Fe3 plus of concentration 0.003 molar, these two are present in the same phase. So into the mixture of iron 2 plus and iron 3 plus of given concentration, platinum electrode has been immersed. This solution has been separated by potassium permanganate solution or permanganate solution of concentration 0.02 molar, where Mn2 plus is also present in the same phase of MnO4 minus of concentration 0.005 molar. But acidic medium is maintained. To this particular phase, acidic medium of 1 molar concentration has been maintained, and platinum electrode is the electrode immersed into the mixture of permanganate and Mn2 plus and hydrogen ion. What you have to calculate? You have to calculate the potential of each off cell before the reaction, after the reaction, and what is the cell voltage after the reaction. You have to calculate the cell voltage also. At the start of the reaction, before the initiation of the redox reaction, what is the potential you have to calculate. And you have to assume at equilibrium H2SO4 to be completely ionized and in equal volumes in each. So H2SO4 is going to be completely ionized in equal volumes in each. What is the potential you have to calculate at equilibrium? Okay. So you are aware about the redox reaction takes place between iron 2 plus and MnO4 minus. Here, potassium permanganate is going to be the oxidizing agent, and its oxidation potential is more when compared to Mn2 plus. Here, iron 2 plus is the reducing agent. So its reduction potential is more when compared to iron 3 plus, because when you consider this electrochemical cell, this is the overall representation of the electrochemical cell. The off cell present in the left hand side is going to be anode, and the off cell present in the right hand side is going to be cathode. So potassium permanganate is an oxidizing agent, it should undergo reduction. Iron 2 plus is a reducing agent, it should undergo oxidation. So that's what the overall redox reaction can be written as: Fe2 plus plus MnO4 minus plus 8H plus gives rise to 5Fe3 plus plus Mn2 plus plus 4H2O. This is the balanced overall redox reaction takes place between strong reducing agent iron 2 plus and oxidizing agent potassium permanganate in the presence of acidic medium. Because H plus ion of activity 1 molar, H plus ion of concentration 1 molar has been maintained at RHS. Okay, let us proceed with the given problems. So what they are asked? They are asking to calculate the potential of each off cell before the reaction. Before the reaction means no reaction is initiated between iron 2 plus and MnO4 minus. So they are not yet mixed. So we have to calculate the E value before the reaction means for both cathode and anode. For both cathode and anode. So what is the species present in anodic off cell? Iron. What is the species present in cathodic off cell? Manganese. Manganese from potassium permanganate, iron from Fe2+. So let us calculate the E value for both the species. So EFE is equal to E naught of iron 3 iron 2 couple minus 0.0591 divided by N into log of concentration of iron 2 plus divided by concentration of iron 3 plus, where N value will be 1, because iron 2 plus undergo oxidation to get converted to iron 3 plus. Only one electron has been removed from iron 2 plus. Only one electron has been removed from iron 2 plus. Therefore, the value of N will be unity. So E naught value of iron 3 iron 2 couple, you know, that is going to be 0.771 volts minus 0.0591 divided by 1 into log of concentration of Fe2 plus is given in the systematic representation of the electrochemical cell. Concentration of Fe2 plus is 0.15 molar and concentration of Fe3 plus is 0.003 molar, because we are at before the reaction. So 0.15 molar is the concentration of iron 2 plus, 0.003 molar is the concentration of iron 3 plus. So EFE or E value for the left hand side cell is going to give you 0.671 volts. Similarly, for the right hand cell, EMN, manganese is the species involved there in the aqueous solution. So EMN is equal to E naught of Mn7, Mn2 couple. Mn7 means permanganate, and Mn2 is also present in the phase at which permanganate is present. So E naught of permanganate and Mn2 plus minus 0.05916 divided by N. Here the value of N is going to be 5, because manganese 7 in permanganate undergo reduction to get converted to manganese 2. So it is a 5 electron change reaction. Therefore, the value of N is going to give you 5 into log of Mn2 plus concentration divided by MnO4 minus concentration divided by H plus ion concentration to the power 8. If you write the off reaction for potassium permanganate reduction, you will get MnO4 minus MnO4 minus plus 8H plus plus 5 electrons gives rise to Mn2 plus plus 4H2O. So if you write the off reaction for the reduction of MnO4 minus, you will get MnO4 minus plus 8H plus plus 5 electrons gives rise to Mn2 plus plus 4H2O. Because MnO4 minus is an oxidizing agent, it should undergo reduction. So what is the product of reduction of MnO4 minus? That is going to be Mn2 plus. So MnO4 minus concentration is given, Mn2 plus concentration is given, hydrogen ion concentration is given. If you just substitute in place of Mn2 plus concentration by 0.005 and in place of MnO4 minus as 0.02 and H plus ion concentration is given as 1 molar. So to the power 8 you substitute, you will get EMN is equal to 1.52 volts. Okay, let us move on to the second part. We have to calculate the E value at equilibrium. What is the state of equilibrium? State of equilibrium means it is a state of a chemical reaction at which neither analyte nor reactant left over. If you assume iron as an analyte, reactant is going to be manganese or manganese 7. So neither iron 2 nor permanganate left over. Iron 2 has been converted to iron 3 by oxidation process, and permanganate has been converted to Mn2 plus by reduction process. So neither Fe2 plus nor permanganate left over. In an alternative way, the E cell value for the conversion of iron 2 to iron 3 will be exactly equal to the E cell value for the conversion of permanganate to Mn2. Okay, so EFE is equal to EMN. Therefore, we know that the chemical reaction between iron 2 and permanganate is given like this: 5Fe2 plus plus MnO4 minus plus 8H plus plus 5 electrons gives rise to 5Fe2 plus plus Mn2 plus plus 4H2O. We know EFE is equal to E manganese at the state of equilibrium. Therefore, we know for the EFE from the above, EFE is equal to 0.771 minus 0.0591 into log of iron 2 plus concentration divided by iron 3 plus concentration. So, in order to substitute into this equation, we have to calculate the concentration of iron 2 plus and concentration of iron 3 plus. Okay, the initial concentration of iron 2 plus was 0.15 molar. The concentration of MnO4 minus added was 0.02 molar. You can see from this, the concentration of iron 2 plus was 0.15 molar and permanganate added was 0.02 molar. So we know that 1 mole of permanganate reacts with 5 moles of Fe2 plus. This you know from the electron stoichiometry, 1 mole of permanganate reacts with 5 moles of Fe2 plus. Therefore, iron 2 plus consumed in the reaction, or iron 2 plus underwent oxidation is equal to 5 into 0.02, that is going to give you 0.1 molar, 0.1 molar. Therefore, this is the amount of iron 2 plus underwent for chemical reaction, 0.1 molar amount of iron 2 plus consumed or underwent for chemical reaction. Therefore, what is the amount of iron 2 plus left? 0.15 minus 0.1, you are going to get 0.05 molar. 0.05 molar. So, the concentration of iron 2 plus leftover is going to give you 0.05 molar. Similarly, you can calculate what is the amount of iron 3 plus formed. The concentration of iron 3 plus formed is going to be 0.1 molar. How do you get this? Iron 2 plus left is 0.05 molar. Iron 2 plus taken is 0.15 molar. So 0.15 minus 0.05, you're going to get 0.1 molar. Iron 3 plus formed is 0.1 molar. Out of 0.15 molar iron 2 plus, 0.05 molar iron 2 plus left over after the redox reaction is over. So the concentration of iron 3 plus formed is going to be 0.1 molar. Thus, the total iron 3 plus formed, this is 0.1 molar concentration of iron 3 plus formed by oxidation of iron 2 plus. But in the electrochemical cell, there is iron 3 plus present initially in an amount 0.003 molar. This is the concentration, initial concentration of iron 3 plus before the start of the chemical reaction. So that is present in the same phase along with iron 2 plus. So that you have to sum up with iron 3 plus form. 0.1 plus 0.003, you are going to get 0.103 molar. Therefore, we know E manganese is equal to EFE. So EFE is equal to E naught of iron 3 iron 2 couple, that is 0.771 minus 0.05916 divided by N. N is going to be 1 into log of iron 2 plus concentration divided by iron 3 plus concentration. Iron 2 plus concentration is 0.05 molar. You substitute, and iron 3 plus concentration is 0.103 molar. You substitute, and E manganese or EFE value will be 0.790 volts. Okay, next let us move on to the next part. What is the E cell value at the start of the reaction? At the start of the reaction, E cell value will be simply equal to E cathode minus E anode. Potassium permanganate is going to be the species to undergo reduction, and iron 2 is the species to undergo oxidation. Therefore, E cathode minus E anode. So, the cathodic potential is known, that is 1.52, and anodic potential is also known, that is 0.671. Here we have calculated. EFE is 0.671 and E manganese is 1.52, because they are asked to calculate the E cell value at the start of the reaction. So, at the start of the reaction, E value for iron 2 iron 3 couple is 0.671 and E value for permanganate manganese 2 couple is 1.52 volts. You just substitute. E cell is equal to E cathode minus E anode. E cathode is going to be E manganese and E anode is going to be E iron. So 1.52 minus 0.671, you will be getting E cell is equal to 0.85 volts. This is very simple to calculate. So that's over. Next part. At equilibrium, what is the E cell value? They are asked. At equilibrium, assume S2SO4 to be completely ionized. S2SO4 to be completely ionized. So, it is not going to influence any species to be left over. Any species among the reactants to be left over. So, at equilibrium, neither potassium permanganate or permanganate nor iron 2 plus left over. So, E cell value generated due to the reduction of permanganate will be exactly equal to the E cell value due to the oxidation of iron 2 plus. So, EMnO4Mn2 couple minus E iron 2 iron 3 couple will be 0, or E permanganate to manganese 2 will be exactly equal to E of iron 2 to iron 3 couple. Therefore, E cell value will be exactly 0. E cell value will be exactly 0 at equilibrium, because Neither iron 2 plus nor MnO4 minus left over at equilibrium. The reaction is 100% completed. So after the completion of 100% of the reaction, neither the reactant nor the analyte species left over, means iron 2 plus or potassium permanganate are not left over in the solution. Therefore, the E cell value will be exactly 0 volts. So this is how we can calculate the voltage or E cell value at different instances of the chemical reactions by using the systematic representation of the electrochemical cells and the Nernst equation. Let us move on to the next one. This is something different than the other problems what we have solved so far. Calculate Kw, the ionic product constant of water, for the reaction H2O gives rise to H plus plus OH minus. This is the problem, very simple. They have given nothing. So you must be very familiar about the ionization of water or dissociation of water. So the equilibrium constant for ionization of water is called as ionic product constant, that is denoted by Kw. So by using the Nernst equation, the principle of electrochemistry, you should have the knowledge of electrochemical cell and you should have the knowledge of Nernst equation, and you should know about the relationship between the concentration of H plus and OH minus ions with the Kw value. Okay, so you have to calculate the value of Kw, ionic product constant of water, for the reaction H2O gives rise to H plus plus OH minus. So let us start solving this problem. Water undergo reduction to get hydrogen gas, and you are aware about this reaction from the hydrogen electrode, standard hydrogen electrode or normal hydrogen electrode. Water undergo reduction to get converted to hydrogen gas, plus OH minus. This is going to be plus hydrogen gas and OH minus. So H2O plus electron gives rise to 0.5 H2 plus OH minus, So H2O plus electron gives rise to 0.5 H2 plus OH minus. From the electrochemical series, you can have the standard state reduction potential for this particular reaction as minus 0.83 volts. Similarly, the hydrogen ion, which is obtained due to ionization of water, will also undergo reduction to get converted to hydrogen gas. So H plus plus electron gives rise to 0.5 H2, and the E naught value for this will be exactly 0. So what is the overall reaction? The overall reaction is H2O gives rise to H plus plus OH minus. H2O gives rise to H plus plus OH minus. So you can reverse this. 0.5 H2 gives rise to H plus plus an electron. This is going to be oxidation reaction and this is going to be reduction reaction. So the overall reaction is H2O gives rise to H plus plus OH minus. These are the two species, and 0.5 H2, 0.5 H2, one electron are going to be cancelled. So you are left with H2O gives rise to H plus and OH minus. So the E naught of this overall reaction is simply E naught of the cathode, that is minus 0.83 volts, minus E naught of the anode. If you consider this as an anode, this is going to be E naught of the anode. E naught of the anode is 0, so minus 0.83 minus 0, you are going to get minus 0.83 volts. So E naught is obtained. We know from the Nernst equation E is equal to E naught minus 0.0591 divided by N into log of H plus ion concentration into OH minus concentration. So these two are the products of ionization of water. N value is going to be 1. In either equations, the value of N is going to be exactly 1, because only one electron change reaction. One electron has been added to water and one electron has been removed from hydrogen gas in the oxidation process. So E is equal to E naught value, you know, you just substitute minus 0.83 volts minus 0.0591 divided by 1 into log of H plus ion concentration into OH minus ion concentration. You know the product of H plus ion and OH minus concentrations is going to be Kw, that is ionic product constant. Ionic product constant. So E is equal to the potential of the electrochemical cell is going to be E naught minus 0.05916 into log of ionic product constant. But you also know that at equilibrium state, E value will be zero. As I told you, either the reactants are going to be, either the reactants are not going to be present at the state of equilibrium. So E value will be exactly equal to zero because E cathode minus E anode is going to be zero. Cathodic potential will be exactly equal to anodic potential. Therefore, the overall potential of the electrochemical cell is also going to be zero. So E value will be zero at equilibrium. Therefore, 0 is equal to minus 0.83 minus 0.0591 into log Kw. So log Kw you are going to get as minus 0.83 divided by 0.0591. Finally, if you just take the anti-log for the answer, what you get after dividing minus 0.83 by 0.0591, you will get Kw as 1 into 10 power minus 14. So this is a constant, ionic product constant. If you calculate at any temperature, the ionic product constant of water will be 1 into 10 power minus 14 only. So this is how, provided the E naught value for given off reaction and the state of concentrations, or if you have prior knowledge on the species and its extent of presentation, you can easily calculate the equilibrium constant for any given chemical reaction. Not only this reaction, you consider any chemical reaction it may be. Once the reactants reach their equilibrium state at the state of equilibration level, neither the reactants nor the analytes will be left over. So E cell value will be exactly going to be zero. With that knowledge, you can calculate the equilibrium constant. So equilibrium constant, as you know, from the Nernst equation, can be written as 0.0591 into log K is going to give you E naught value. So E naught is equal to 0.0591 into log K. So log K is equal to E naught divided by 0.0591. So K is equal to anti-log of K is equal to anti-log of E naught divided by 0.0591. You can simply calculate. So this is how not only Kw, the equilibrium constant for any chemical reaction can be easily calculated by using the Nernst equation. For that, you must remember about the E value at equilibrium state, that should be exactly zero. Let us move on to the next one. In a similar manner, what we have done in order to calculate the Kw value for water ionization or dissociation of water, calculate the Ksp of dihydroxymanganese or manganese hydroxide. If the reaction is MnOH twice gives rise to Mn2 plus plus 2OH minus. Ksp value of manganese hydroxide you have to calculate. Ksp means solubility product constant. Just like ionic product constant Kw, Ksp is a solubility product constant, and this is holds good for chemical reactions which are going to yield insoluble residues. So say for example, Ag plus reacts with chloride to form AgCl. Ksp of AgCl you will be knowing. Similarly, MnOH twice gives rise to Mn2 plus plus 2OH minus. If you write this in reverse order, Mn2 plus react with hydroxyl ion to produce a precipitate of dihydroxymanganese. So this is an insoluble residue or slightly dissociated product, and it will be having the equilibrium constant of Ksp. Equilibrium constant of Ksp, where the Ksp value for this reaction will be simply the product of concentration of Mn2 plus and concentration of OH minus to the power 2. The Ksp of dihydroxymanganese is going to be concentration of Mn2 plus into concentration of OH minus to the power 2 according to law of mass action. So Ksp can be written for any chemical reactions, and they are particularly for the dissociation of the insoluble residue. You take any insoluble residue such as AgCl or manganese hydroxide or AgBr or AgI or AgF or silver cyanide, silver thiocyanate, right, whatever it is, you write any dissociation reaction for insoluble residue. That insoluble residue will be undergoing the dissociation to very less extent. So as the value of Ksp is going to be larger, its solubility, its dissociation will be larger. As the value of Ksp is going to be lesser, the dissociability of the precipitate or the insoluble residue is going to be lesser. Means if the Ksp value is lesser, the product is not going to be dissociated to the major extent. Therefore, if you consider MnOH twice, this will dissociate to get Mn2 plus plus 2OH minus. For this reaction, you have to calculate Ksp value. Okay, let us proceed how to calculate the Ksp value for this. We know MnOH twice undergo reduction by capturing 2 electrons to give solid manganese and 2 hydroxyl ions. Manganese, elemental manganese is going to be obtained due to the reduction of Mn2, Mn2 plus, MnOH twice means Mn2 plus capture 2 electrons in order to get elemental manganese with the consequent formation of hydroxyl ion. From the electrochemical series, you can obtain the value of E0, that is minus 1.59 volts. Similarly, Mn2 plus plus 2 electrons going to give you Mn solid. So this is the reduction reaction for manganese dihydroxide. This is the reduction reaction for Mn2 plus, because we have to write the oxidation of manganese. Oxidation of manganese is going to be Mn gives rise to Mn2 plus plus 2 electrons. In order to substitute the values into the Nernst equation, the oxidation reaction has been reversed in such a way that Mn2 plus plus 2 electrons gives rise to Mn solid. The E0 value for this reaction will be minus 1.18 volts. Minus 1.18 volts. Here, this is more negative than this. Minus 1.59 volts is lesser than minus 1.18 volts. So this is the strong reducing agent. The strong reducing agent, and this is going to be the oxidizing agent. Therefore, the overall reaction is MnOH twice gives rise to Mn2 plus plus 2OH minus. E0 is equal to E0 of the cathode minus E0 of the anode. This is the E0 of the cathode because this is more negative than this. E0 of the cathode is minus 1.59 volts and E0 of the anode is minus 1.18 volts. So if you simplify, you will get minus 0.41 volts. So if you go to the Nernst equation, which can be used to calculate the E cell value, E cell is equal to E0 minus 0.0591 divided by N into log of ratio of the concentrations of product to the reactants. So E is equal to E0, you know, minus 0.41 volts minus 0.0591 divided by 2 is the number of electrons which are concerned for the reduction of Mn2 plus or the reduction of manganese dihydroxide into log of Mn2 plus concentration for this particular reaction, Mn2 plus concentration into OH minus concentration to the power 2. So Mn2 plus concentration into OH minus concentration to the power 2 according to law of mass action. Because this is a dissociation reaction of the insoluble residue MnOH twice. Therefore, the equilibrium constant for this reaction is going to be the solubility product constant for Mn2 plus and OH minus product, that is MnOH twice. So the product of concentration of Mn2 plus and OH minus concentration to the power 2 is going to give you the Ksp value of manganese dihydroxide is one thing. And the second thing is, if the reaction reached the state of equilibrium, the value of E will be exactly zero, as I told in the previous problem. At equilibrium, E value will be exactly zero. And you know the value of Ksp, that is product of concentration of Mn2 plus and OH minus concentration to the power 2. So log Ksp, you will get it as log Ksp is equal to minus 0.41, because E value will be 0. So minus 0.41 will be equal to 0.0591 divided by 2 into log Ksp. So log Ksp is equal to 2 into minus 0.41 divided by 0.0591, you will be getting minus 13.90. So if you take anti-log for the